In Visual Studio Code, when working with block-level comments in CSS or HTML, for example, you often end up in a situation where you want to remove a certain comment, but you accidentally add another line comment exactly where you don't want it. And this can be very frustrating and very time-consuming to deal with. Luckily, there is a very simple solution built into Visual Studio Code. It's just not enabled by default. In this video, I will show you exactly how to solve this problem once and for all without installing additional extensions. Let's dive in. There is a major usability issue when working with block-level comments in languages that only support block-level comments. These are CSS and HTML to be specific. I have a CSS file open here, and if I want to add a comment, I have to select the lines that I want to comment out, and then I have to hit my comment shortcut on the keyboard. And now the problem is, if I want to uncomment those particular lines of code, if I want to remove this comment, then I have to select all of those lines that are commented out. Because if I go somewhere within the comment, my expectation is that if I hit my comment shortcut on the keyboard, this comment should be removed. But here is what happens. Another comment is added because Visual Studio Code believes that I want to add another line comment exactly where my mouse cursor is. But this is probably never ever the case. If my cursor is within a certain comment, I actually want to remove that particular comment. The only way to remove this comment in Visual Studio Code by default is to select all the lines where the comment is and then hit comment shortcut on keyboard. But this is frustrating and time consuming because you often end up in a situation exactly as I've shown you, where you add another comment instead of removing the existing one. But there is a better way to deal with block level comments. Visual Studio Code comes with Emmet built in. Emmet is an extension or a plugin that allows you to work much more efficiently in CSS and HTML. One of the actions that Emmet supports is adding or removing comments in CSS and other languages that Emmet supports. I will open my command palette and search for action Emmet Toggle Comment. If I execute this command, the block level comment where my cursor is currently placed will immediately be removed exactly as I would expect. This works in all languages that Emmet supports, which includes CSS and HTML as well. Those are the most problematic languages because you have to use block level comments as they don't support single line comments, as you very well know. Of course, it's not very practical to always open command palette when you want to remove a certain block level comment, but instead you want to handle that with keyboard shortcuts. So let's see how this works. I will open my keyboard shortcuts using the command palette, open keyboard shortcuts command, and here I will search for Emmet Toggle Comment. I can assign a separate shortcut for this command, but that's also not very practical because I don't want to be using two different shortcuts for adding or removing comments. So instead, I can assign already existing Visual Studio Code shortcut to this particular action. In my case, this is command slash. I will enter it here and let's test out if this actually works. I will jump back to my CSS file. Let's comment out this part of code again. And now when my cursor is within that comment that I want to remove, if I hit my keyboard comment shortcut, the comment will be immediately removed. And this will not only work in CSS, but it will also work in HTML as you would expect. For example, here is a comment that I've added. And if I hit my comment shortcut, it will be removed exactly as I want. There is one major problem with this. Emmet doesn't support all languages, or specifically, it doesn't support JavaScript. So if I jump into a JavaScript file, and if I want to toggle a comment using my keyboard shortcut, it won't work because we've assigned an Emmet action to the comment shortcut, and we've overwritten the default Visual Studio Code shortcut. That's not what we want. We actually want to be able to set comments in our JavaScript files and in all other files that Emmet doesn't support. So how can we solve this? We can restrict the keyboard shortcut that we just created only to CSS and HTML files or any other file that you're working with and that Emmet specifically supports. Let's see how this works. I will open my keyboard shortcuts tab again. And if I right click this key binding here, I can open the option show same key bindings. This will show me all other actions in Visual Studio Code that have exactly the same key binding. And this is of course toggle line comment and toggle explain mode, which is not really relevant. And as you can see here, toggle line comment action only happens when editor is focused and when it's not in read-only mode. So we will want to apply exactly the same restriction to our toggle comment from Emmet, change when expression. I will copy this and I will enter it right here. I'll paste this in, but I also want to restrict this only to CSS and HTML files. I can do this if I set resource extension name action here. I will add another and command here, and I will set resource extension name has to be equal to .css. There we go. This should now work with CSS files, but only with CSS files. Let's try it out in CSS. If I set a comment here, and if I want to remove it, it works. And in JavaScript, my normal comment binding should work. Let's try it out. It does work exactly as you see right here. But now we have problem in our HTML because we didn't set this for HTML files as well. So if I add a comment here, and if I want to remove it, I'll have exactly the problem that I don't want to have. So we will add another condition to our when statement here, change when expression. And we will enable this for files with the extension CSS or when resource extension name is .html. There we go. So now our when statement reads when editor text is in focus, when editor is not in read mode, and when the resource extension name is either CSS or HTML. Let's try our HTML file here. I will try to toggle my comment and it works exactly as I would expect. My JavaScript file is working as well, as you can see right here. And of course, my toggle comment in CSS is working exactly as it should. If you want to enable this keyboard shortcut for different languages that Emmet supports, you can add them right here in keyboard shortcuts to the when statement. The only downside with this is that it doesn't support JavaScript files. So if you're working with block level comments in JavaScript, this will not work using the Emmet extension and you will have to find a different solution. But by default, JavaScript works with single line comments, so this is probably not a big issue. In any case, if you're working with CSS and HTML files, using the Emmet toggle command, which comes bundled with Visual Studio Code, will save you a lot of problems and a lot of frustrations when dealing with comments. Did you already know about this, or will you start using this now? Please let me know in the comments. Thank you so much for your attention. My name is Zoran Nyambor. I will see and hear you in a different Visual Studio Code keyboard shortcut, or rather, in the next video. And until then, smash that subscribe button so you don't miss any more amazing Visual Studio Code or CSS tips like this one. Bye.